Sounds good. Sounds good. I'm so glad you are all here. So glad to see you and glad to do this, actually. I'm going to share my screen with you guys. Let me get there. All right. Says that I'm screen sharing. So let's see. Can you now see my screen?
Yes, we can.
Yes.
Okay, great. Awesome, awesome. Well, this topic is truly one that is, it's so important, but it's just one that's really important to me as well. And I have to say that I have grown in my experience in being able to qualify and launch our ambassadors and our team members, and then being a consistent leader. So I think that we're all in a constant growing stage with this. I know that I have been, and I know that I continue to be. So the things that I'm sharing with you tonight are probably not going to be new to you at all, but just reminders for all of us of how important these are, what we need to be focusing on and concentrating on, and why we need to be doing that as well. First of all, it made sense to me as we're beginning thinking about growing our teams that the first thing that we start with is actually qualifying those that we want to become team members. Qualifying doesn't mean that we're standing in judgment over someone in any way whatsoever of saying, well, I think you need to be a customer and I think you need to be a team member, you need to be an ambassador. That's not what it means. Qualifying our teams just simply means that we're listening, that we are listening to our prospects, that we are hearing their heart of what they want to do, hearing their needs, hearing their visions, and then guiding them in the direction that is best for them. But in order for someone to be a team member with us, actually an ambassador with us, there are some important things to remember. First of all, they need to remember, we need to remember as we're talking to them that they need to be coachable. They need to be teachable. Do they need to know everything? Absolutely not. None of us knew everything when we started in network marketing. None of us knew everything when if we'd even been in network marketing previously, we didn't know everything when we started with the new company. Absolutely not. We don't need to know everything. We just need to be coachable and we need to be teachable. We also need to have ambassadors as team members that are willing to work hard and that they know that there is an investment. There is a time investment involved, especially at the beginning. There's a time investment involved because there's a launch call that will be some time invested. There's a launch video of where there will be time invested. So those are important things that we look for and that we listen for when we're talking to individual prospects. It's also important that as we're talking to a prospect, that they are very willing to actually have their auto ship on with 100 PV minimum. And I just insist on being extremely honest with people. We all know that you do not have to keep your auto ship on. We know that it can be changed at any time, that it can be turned off and on. However, the way I've worded this when I have prospects as team members, I've worded it as the expectation is that you have a monthly auto ship with 100 minimum PV. And that's an expectation that is met for every single month. And I also state with them that the expectation is that you're willing to participate in a launch call, and that launch call needs to be very quickly and right away. So those things are the things that we talk about with prospects, and we listen to them and we hear their hearts. We just find out where they are right now because the timing has to be right for them. If they're hesitant in any of these, in the ability to have the time investment right now, the ability to have the monthly auto ship, then it's really okay to suggest to them, say, then we need to, let's set you up as a customer. Just a very gentle wording of, the time is probably not right now for you to be a team member. Let's get you started as a customer. Let's get you started on the products so you can become an absolute lover of these products. And then I know at some point you're going to want to be able to share these products. And at that time, we can easily talk about changing you into an ambassador with no problem whatsoever. So qualifying your people, I've come to realize how very, very important this is. Something that keeps coming to me is just quality over quantity. I didn't always know that, nor did I always believe that. But I very much do now. It's quality over quantity. It's those that are ready. It's those that the timing is right for them. It's those that are willing to be committed, those that are willing to be consistent, because those are the ones that are truly going to work with you. Let me go to the next one. So that brings us to launching. So once we've qualified, we know that this person is ready, the timing is right for them, the vision is right for them, the need is right for them, then it's time for the launch. Very, very important that the launch occurs within 24 to 48 hours after joining, if at all possible. And we all know that that's not always possible, just with different things going on. Sometimes you hit the holidays, just as we did this week. We'll be coming into more holidays. So we know that that's not always a possibility, but that's the absolute best thing, if at all possible. Because you've heard it said several times that when you start with the excitement, then you can get things going quicker, because at the beginning, their excitement level will be high, their fear level will be lower. But as the days go on, those two tend to start moving closer together. The excitement fades, the fear goes up, and eventually the fear is above the excitement level. And we've all been there. Think about when you've been at convention. Think about when you've been at an event. You're so excited when you leave those events. You're ready to go. You're just ready to hit it hard and just do everything you can. But it's not very many hours or days in the future that you start to second guess yourself. Things start to come in, things start to get in the way. So that excitement that you had at convention didn't go. So that's exactly what happens with our new ambassadors. So capitalize on that excitement. That's the most important thing, because then that excitement will override the fear. And that's going to help them, and we'll get them earning money, we'll get them going quicker. And then that just helps them tremendously and helps them be more successful and earn money and get money in their pockets quicker. Also, our launching allows for duplication. It allows for us to use the system. If we use the system, then we duplicate, and then those people duplicate, and those people duplicate. And then before we know it, our businesses have all grown tremendously, because that is the way we duplicate, is through launching. Getting our ambassadors launched, getting them launched quickly, and getting them launched correctly. We don't have to know everything, because we always have help. We always have our sponsors. We always have our mentors. So I know that some of you are brand new ambassadors, so you're not going to be launching your own people yet. Your mentors will, your sponsors will. However, you will be at some point. So this will be so very important to you to know these things. Very important. Even if you're not launching now, you will be in the near future. So what are the steps of launching? So we've qualified people. We know that launching is important. So what do we do? The first thing that you do is send them our Welcome to Q Sciences document. I know that Jenny has done one for us. We have an updated one from Jenny. Those things are so important to have handy in your phone. I have one in my set of notes. I actually have those that I've messaged to myself in Messenger. So I have them in two places. I can find them easily. I know where they are. I can immediately send them to any new ambassador. So when you have that saved in your notes, saved somewhere so that you can send it, you send that immediately to your new ambassador and stress the importance of it. What I have found out is that a lot of times, if I don't stress the importance of it, then the activities in there, the steps in there don't get done. So stress the importance of that document, stress the importance of going through it as quickly as possible, and following it as detailed as possible. And then once you send that to them, then you're going to schedule with them a goal setting call, a launch call, a vision call, whatever you want to call it, but you're going to schedule an actual launch call with your new ambassador. And that is going to, if it's your new ambassador, then keep in mind, you're not doing the launch call, your sponsor is doing the launch call. For instance, if I have a new ambassador, then Jenny is going to do my launch call for me. That helps your new ambassador see that you really don't need to know everything. We have help. We have mentors available. We have sponsors available. We have third-party tools available. It's a system we can follow, and anybody can follow it as long as we're coachable, as long as we're teachable. So you schedule their launch call with your sponsor and with them. And then that call takes off. However, and I always like to stress to my ambassadors as well that as many times as I've tried, I really cannot get that call much under an hour, if at all under an hour. So I do stress to the new ambassador that this call will take right around an hour, because by the time I answer questions and we work through the launch document, then the time is gone. So working through that launch document, to me, the most important thing is you start to work through that launch document with them. They really don't have to have it filled out as they come to the meeting, but to have it with them, in front of them, printed off. But the most important thing to me is to be extremely sensitive to them and listen. Listen to what their visions are. Listen to what their needs are. If they are coming to you and they really need to replace a $4,000 a month income, then their goals and how you're going to help them will look much different than if you're helping someone become builder pro executive. So listen closely to what they want, what their needs are. If those desires, visions tend to be a little bit too ambitious, you might want to help them kind of scale things back a little bit, but you never want to discourage anyone either. Always encourage them to shoot for what their needs are and what their visions are. But main part of that document, one of the very main parts of the document, is to help them set goals. And actual goals, by setting goals, literally, this is how you become builder. This is how you become pro. This is how you become executive. If we get you two ambassadors and they get an ambassador, or you get two ambassadors and two to three customers, then you're on your way to becoming builder and pro. Just to literally detail it out, this is how you become builder. This is how many orders you need to become pro, and this is how many you need to become executive. And the same, if they need a $4,000 a month income, then you're going to actually outline for them, this month you'll do this in order to get you to executive. This month you will do this in order to get you to elite, and then bronze, and then silver. So they know exactly how many orders are required in each of those. So hopefully that all makes sense, but just my main thought there was just that we have to listen and be sensitive to what their needs are. And then once their goals are set, it's so important to outline, here are the next steps. This is what we do. Jenny has taught me that so very much. We need to kind of, And I know you don't really want to say handhold, but we really need to guide them at first to help them know exactly what the next steps are. So the first thing that you want to do after you've set goals is to help them with a peak post. Jenny has given us so many helpful first post ideas. I have all of those saved. You can find many of those, but to give them peak post ideas. Best thing is to have them send it back to you. Either help them write it right then, that first peak post, or give them a general outline, help them with a general outline, let them come back right to you. Another thing that Jenny really stressed was important, and I found it to be extremely helpful, is to set an exact time. Okay, if you're doing your call on a Monday, then okay, tomorrow at noon, please send me your peak post so I can help you review it and you can get it out on Tuesday night during that peak time on Facebook or Instagram. The next step after their peak post is that you need to help them with inviting to their Fab Five. The goal is to get at least five yeses, to help them get five yeses to a Fab Five, so that they have five people on there that are ready to listen, ready to hear, ready to hear some of the product info, ready to hear some of the business info. Because the next ultimate goal is to get them two team members that are willing to run with them. So help them with inviting. Once again, we have all kinds of language, all kinds of examples on inviting to Fab Fives. If you don't have those things, please contact us. Please contact Jenny. You're welcome to contact me. I have all of those kind of things saved in my phone where I can easily send those out to people. Ideas on peak posts, ideas on wording for Fab, inviting to Fab Fives, messaging, and actually picking up the phone and calling. I know a lot of times you don't have phone numbers for people. So messages are the way that you have to go, but absolute best is to pick up the phone and call and let them hear your voice. If not, let them hear a voicemail message. The third thing that you help them with and understanding is IPA. What are they going to do every single day that's going to get them towards their goal? So they've set a goal, they want to get there. So what are they going to do daily? Once again, we have several IPA worksheets suggested. Jenny has given us several. I have others saved. So there are several examples of those. But the one thing that I like to stress to my new team members and to all of my ambassadors is that decide how much time you have every day to spend. How much time can you commit every day to your business? And then commit that time every day. I used to think that it was really okay to say, okay, well, I'm going to commit 2 hours on Tuesday and 2 hours on Thursday. But what I found, it really is much more efficient to me, much more effective for me. If I only have 30 minutes a day, then 30 minutes a day is what I'll do. But it's every single day. Just the consistency of that, a couple of reasons for that. For one thing, people get used to you messaging them and talking to them and following up with them. They're going to expect that. Another thing is your social media. Social media, I found out very quickly, if you take a few days off of social media, it's very hard to regain the momentum that you had with social media that you would have had if you had continued day after day. Just a little consistency every day. So you've helped them with a peak post. You've helped, so people know what they're doing, know that they've started. You've helped them with inviting to Fab Fives. You've helped them knowing what to do each day, whether it's messaging people directly, posting on Facebook, all of those first post ideas, but you've helped them know exactly what to do every day. And then the next thing that you help them understand is that once they have interested individuals, that's the time for them to get them on calls with you, your mentor, their sponsor, whoever can help them the most get their prospects onto third-party calls. Third-party calls have worked tremendously for me. I've never ceased to be amazed at how much Jenny is available to help. And if she feels like that we need to get someone else involved, we can get someone else involved, just depending on what that particular prospect needs. It's just been amazing. But we do have those kind of things available to you. So those are the steps of launching. The same thing every time. The system is there. The system is in the launch document. Talking over that system is so very important because it's going to pique their interest, send them a video or get them on a call, a QIQ, get them with a third party call. And it's just the same continued thing. And that's very important to stress with launching. So once we've actually launched them, then the next most important thing is that our own leadership has to be consistent. If our own leadership with our new ambassadors is not consistent, then truthfully, how can we expect them to be consistent at all? So the thoughts that came to me were that an important thing is to just be available. Be available when they need you. Always thinking, okay, and sometimes it's hard. Sometimes we are busy and sometimes it is a time, but it's okay to say, you bet, I'll help you. May I check in with you at this particular time? I'm not available right now, but I will definitely be available for you at this time and this time. But our availability as a leader is very, very important. We don't want to check out on them. We don't want to get them launched and then all of a sudden they do not see us for 3 weeks, nor hear from us for 3 weeks. We will lose an ambassador that way, just to be very honest. They won't be earning money. They won't be, the excitement will have gone away and the fear would have risen. And so very important to be there and be available and don't check out on them. Always check in with them. That comes to the next thing, or the weekly check-ins. I try to always weekly check in with ambassadors in some form or another, whether I see them face to face, whether I just message quickly. Most important reason for that is weekly pay. And if they don't understand where they are and where they could be by that end of the week weekly pay period, then they're not going to be as readily eager to work and to get busy on that. Sometimes people are just one order away, two orders away from a weekly paycheck and they didn't realize it. So that's one thing that we need to always do is look at reports, look at the ambassador volume tracker report, see where people are, and help them know what they need to do to actually get a weekly paycheck. Another thing that we need to check on constantly are auto ships, just to make sure that our team members have their auto ships on, that they're set for 100 PV. So important to them because they are not commission qualified if their auto ship is not on. So they could be earning a weekly paycheck, but their auto ship is not on. And so therefore, or it's not set at 100 PV. So therefore, we need to make sure that they are commission qualified. Very, very important. Our reports help us do that. If you need help with reports, please check with your sponsor. Those reports can be run. The more I'm looking into reports, the more that's there for us. It's just amazing what's there for us and what information we can have to work off of if we look through the reports. Another thing that's so very important is that I feel is to help our new ambassadors, especially, learn how to use their third-party tools, learn what's in the ARC app, learn what's in their back office. There are so many things there that they can use for not only social media, but for to send to short clips of products to send to prospects. They're just so much. I have a lot of prospects that want product detail. Those are all available to us. Everything, the company has worked so very hard to give us every single tool that we need to be a consistent leader, to be an effective leader. And that helps our business, of course, and then helps all of our team and helps our team grow and helps our team win. And that's the goal. Our goal is to launch correctly, keep them consistent, and keep our leadership consistent so that everybody wins. It's a win-win situation. So I know that's kind of a brief overview, probably not anything new to you, but if you have any questions, I am very willing to help with those. And I know Jenny probably has a lot more to add. So I'll turn it over to her.
So I hope, can you guys hear me?
Let me quit. Yes.
Okay. So I actually don't have hardly anything to add, because to me, that was such a great explanation. And I don't just say that, I mean that wholeheartedly. So there's one thing that I did want to point out, two things actually. First of all, you hear Helen in almost everything that she talks about one thing is a common thread throughout all of that, and that is listening. Sorry, I have kids running around everywhere. That is a, believe it or not, it's a high level skill. It's something that for a while, as you are doing these things, as you're qualifying people, as you're launching them, as you're leading them, you are going to feel like you're not ready. And whenever I see someone come in and know that they're not ready, but they decide to like dive in and do things anyway, that's whenever I know someone's going to be great. Because I feel like I'm not ready every day. I still feel like I don't know exactly what I'm doing. I still feel like I don't know exactly how to do this or do that, but you just have to get in there with people. They don't expect perfection from you. They just expect you to show up. And so what I've learned, and bringing this back to the listening thing, is that you will develop your own methods for doing these things. You'll decide which sheets you like to use best, and you'll decide how much you want to go into on a launch call or a goal setting call. And you'll decide if you like my method better or Helen's method better or Danielle's method better or Fran's method better. As you get to watch those things, you'll take bits and pieces from each one. But then as you've done this over time, you're going to learn that the listening aspect is really important, and it helps you determine where a person's at so that you can help qualify them before you ever really ask them any of those questions. It's going to help you with your launch process so that you know, okay, is this person getting overwhelmed? Have I given them too much? Or do I need to, you know, just dive in and go even further with them? Do I need to back off on the comp plan training and go more into like, okay, here's your first step and stop there? Or is this a person that wants the next five steps and I need to be prepared to buck up and give that to them? With your leading, that is something that's constantly evolving with the season, with the time, with what's happening with the company, with what's happening with your team. But if you get really good at listening to other people and then just acting from your gut and like doing the things without questioning yourself over and over, you're gonna find that you actually get really good at all three of these things that Helen has talked about. There are so many people on our team that are so great at them. And it's just because they've done it over and over, even when they felt like they weren't ready, even when they felt like they had no idea what they were doing, they did it anyway. And then you get in a routine and you figure out what works and what doesn't work. And then you get to that high level skill where you can actually listen to the person you're talking to and adjust things based on who you're talking to on every single call or every single training. But I have nothing else to add to that. I mean, I thought that was perfect. There's nothing I would change. So if you guys have questions, y'all are willing to ask them. If not, then it is time to get out and get into activity and get moving your feet. Anybody have questions? No? Okay, Helen, you got anything else?
No, that's good.
Okay. Well, thank y'all so much. I'll get the recording up. And we will wrap up these next 2 days and get started on December.
Sounds good.
Thank you, Helen.
Good night. You're welcome. Good night, everyone.